I love that they're still making out with each other. Oh my gosh, you're naked. Stop. Wait. Guys, that was so fast.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to another episode of The Royal Family. So I've posted a few videos since, but as you can see, Jake and I have moved. We finally moved to LA, which I'm super excited about. For those of you who know or who remember, we've been talking about this for like years, so we're finally moved and we're so happy about it. So this is the new space for now. But yeah, I just had to say that. It's been a couple months since the last episode, but we will go over things in just a second. So there were story posts posted since the last episode on Instagram and on Tumblr, and those are linked below. I will talk about them when we get there in the video, but if you want to go ahead and see them, if you did miss them, again, those are linked below. But in this episode, we have a lot that we're doing, and I know we did a ton in the last episode. The last episode ended up being like almost an hour long, so we're actually also doing a lot in this episode. We will see how long it is. So in this episode, we're going to continue with Ember. And in the last episode, as you guys saw, she made a huge surprise appearance at the Salvadorana Palace, and we saw that she's pregnant. So she thought the dad was William, and we used the Woohoo Wellness mod to have William take a paternity test, and we learned that William is not the father, so thank goodness for that. So now we're gonna have Ember tell Liam about the baby, and we will see how this goes. In this episode, we will also be having Genevieve and John's wedding, and we will be checking in with Arya and Gabriel. We will be spending some time with the Windenburg royal family in Henford because they are on a weekend holiday there, and we're gonna try a new mod with CasMay while we're there. And then we're going to have two babies born. Actually, we might have three, but we're gonna have some babies born, and then we're going to the Guangxi Palace because there is a little event going on there, and we'll be checking in with Kaleo while we're there because he has returned from military school. So if you're excited for this episode, make sure you hit that like button. Okay, so we're now at Liam's household. This should be interesting because for those of you who remember, is that Liam swimming right now? I'm gonna have Ember knock on the door. So for those of you who remember, Ember and Liam's twin sister Eloise used to be best friends, and then they had a falling out, so now they basically hate each other. So she's just showing up here saying she might be pregnant with her twin sister's baby or twin brother's baby. Oh gosh, there's Eloise. They've got a very negative relationship. This is, do you not know his mother? You should know his mother. You should say hello. And then Liam, you want to come here? We have some news we're about to break to you. Oh my gosh, their relationship. Invite to feel baby, call over. And also, Ember's parents are here. This is Liam's stepmother. Attempt introduction. This is Liam and Eloise's stepmother. Wait, Liam, come back, come back. Okay, so now we have to tell him. Wait, I need to pause. So we're going to tell you, invite to feel baby, relationship wellness, announce unwanted pregnancy. Ooh, okay, and then you can tell. All right, so announce the pregnancy. I want to play from Liam's point of view too, so we can see his moodlets and everything and what happened. All right, so Ember, she's supposed to be telling Liam. Where'd you go? Liam, come back. Liam, hold on. I have news. You're in your bathing suit for this. Okay. Pregnancy and family, announce unwanted pregnancy. All right, so she's telling him now, and he's like, wait, what? Now she's like, oh no. Liam, yeah, he's like, pregnancy. I think I read this for William in the last one. Slept with recently, but not truly in a relationship. Announced to him that they are now pregnant. It hits Marquis Liam now, how young and how sometimes stupid he still is. Oh yeah. How little he wants anything major and life-changing happening at this point. The mere idea of being tied down into responsibilities over this makes Marquis Liam nauseous. So hopefully they also slept with someone else and Marquis Liam isn't actually the father. They got pregnant but didn't want to, such a difficult situation, and it makes Marquis Liam troubled to hear about it. Well, sir, I hate to break it to you. Eloise, why do you look so smug right now? She's like, why are you here? Okay, so now you need to tell that it's Liam's. And it did say, if you guys saw, that that's the truth. So
we're about to see what happens. Okay, now Liam is like kind of upset about it. He's like, oh no. He probably asked to take a paternity test too. Oh yeah, he's like, oh my gosh, what? Very tense. Fatherless child from paternity discussion. Marquis Liam's lover says Marquis Liam is the father of their child. This is not a serious relationship, nothing official, and pregnancy was not intended, and Marquis Liam doesn't know what to do about it. Follow the call of responsibility and
Ember!
You just told him he's the father and then you're okay, hold on. Don't do anything else, please, I'm reading. Follow the call of responsibility and develop this relationship further. Make this a hit and run, something in between. Marquis Liam is still too shocked to even think. Could it be Marquis Liam's lover is wrong? Should they check? I mean, you can if you want, but it's the truth, sir. I mean, you would probably check. Ask to marry due to having a child together. No, stop fighting. Stop it. No. Okay, you're acquiring the mischief skill now. Please just take the paternity test, sir. Now you're angry? Peeved? Why are they picking on me? This is not going well. Where's the mailbox? So now they're gonna go take the paternity test. Paternity testing, it's ongoing. Truth is about to be revealed, be it pleasant or not. All right, so as you guys already saw, that's the truth. It is Liam's baby. Okay, so I have the arranged marriages mod. And I've mentioned, have we done it here before? I don't know if we actually have. I've mentioned it before. I did a mod review on it. I'll link it below if you would like to see. But I have the arranged marriages mod. And for this, you can, because they're still teenagers, so I guess we'll do what we did, which, surprise, surprise, Liam's stepmother is Lady Helena, who was our first teen pregnancy of the series, and she had Lord of Jay with Prince Michael, which is Naya's brother, and then they had the baby, but then they were supposed to get married, like, as soon as they turned into young adults. I guess technically we would do that too. It's like they're damage control, so they're betrothed to each other slash engaged. So Wyatt, I'm gonna, Liam, where's your mother? Where is Tina? All right, Lady Tina's here now. So Wyatt, I'm gonna have you, you should do a respectful introduction. We've got a situation to talk about here. So this is the parents trying to do their damage control. They just, their kids being nobles and they're just worried about like reputation and all that stuff. So we're gonna try and see how this goes. Liam's the Marquis of Willow Creek. So that means that Ember would be the Marchioness of Willow Creek. And that means that the Marquis title in Brindleton Bay would be open after Wyatt goes. So we'll see what happens. Because Ember's their only child. I'm gonna feel bad for this child. This is gonna be such a crazy, crazy relationship. A lot of people said they would love if the child turned out to be super sweet. That I would actually think that would be interesting too. Okay, so we're going to go to Other Sims, Arrange Marriage 4. And then, are they back from the test? They're back. Tragedy from paternity test. Marquis Liam hoped so badly that the child was not his, only to have the truth slap him in the face. Okay, arrange marriage for... Really? You can arrange a marriage for your nephew and your niece? Interesting. I didn't know that. Okay. With Mar... Why? Why are ghosts options? Who should Lady Ember be betrothed to? Marquis Liam. They shook on it. Oh, it fast-forwarded, but they did shake on it. Marquis Liam is now betrothed to Lady Ember and will be able to marry when both reach adulthood. So the reason I said maybe we're gonna have three babies born in this episode is because I wasn't sure if Ember was going to, because she is in her third trimester. All right, yep, there we go. It's happening. That's it. The baby's getting born. All right, have baby at hospital. Just send alone, but maybe your parents can go with you. Liam, are you gonna go too? You're going too. Oh my gosh, how does Eloise feel about this? I would love, the entire family is just sitting in the living room. Oh my goodness gracious. Maybe pretend they all went to the hospital or are waiting in the waiting room. That seems more likely, I would hope. Eloise, I don't know how she feels about this, honestly. Ember, her ex-best friend who she hates is now her is going to be her sister-in-law and is going to be the mother of her niece slash nephew, or nephew. It will be the mother of her nephew. Okay, they are having a boy. So, what should this name be? What should this name be? I guess right now I'll change it to Willow, because that's like, once they are married, that's what the last name will be. Willow. So this is Lord
Let's go with Gilbert. Every time I hear Gilbert, I think of Gilbert from Anne of Green Gables. Maybe this will change that now. We have no idea what the future of Gilbert will hold, but I guess we'll find out. So bring Lady Ember here. I might have her move in. Maybe I'll wait just a little bit. Maybe they'll just get their stuff together. I mean, this is Wyatt and, what's your name again? Kayla. This is Wyatt and Kayla's only daughter, so I'm sure they would, like, want to also help out with the baby too. Their first grandchild. But Liam, like, also should be helping with the baby too. So we'll move them in eventually. And I'm sure also Liam's parents too want to also spend time with their grandchild. We'll see. We'll see how this goes. But yeah, okay, they had their baby. They're not betrothed to each other with the arranged marriages mod. In the future, as soon as they turn into young adults, we will have their wedding. So yeah, okay. Speaking of weddings, let's go to Genevieve and John's wedding.
Okay, so we're now at the wedding venue for Genevieve and John. This is actually the venue that Lena and Takashi got married, and also Julia and Manuel, because it was a double wedding. So this is the wedding venue they got married in. This is just where we're gonna have the ceremony, and then we'll go somewhere else for the reception. But this is going to be, one, the smallest wedding we've ever had, and we're going to be having, like, this is the first wedding we're going to be having since the weddings pack came out, so I'm really excited. I'm just waiting for Cornelius. I don't know where he is. I invited him. Okay, there he is. I have teleported him here. We're okay. I don't know why he didn't show up earlier. They're super close. It's important that he's here. There's also some other people here. We're just going to ignore that. We're going to go ahead and start the ceremony. Okay, so please take your seats. So as we all know, when this pack first came out, it was super bug, like an insane amount. We were playing the pack on stream. There was like mods to help make it not so bug, but it was kind of ridiculous that you needed mods for it. So I just asked them. Oh, there we go. Okay, they are gathering at the aisle. Thank goodness. Oh, by the way, this is, oh, I forgot to say. Okay, so the only people that are here, this is why I said it was the smallest wedding, is because it's just obviously John and Genevieve, John's parents, and then Genevieve's brother, two sisters, so Corn, Elena, and Juliet, and then their spouses and their kids, which is just Vivian and Priya. This is the smallest wedding. I feel like this fits them very well. This is probably all they would have wanted. Because it's such a small wedding, I didn't do Sims of Honor. I couldn't really do like Ring Bearer or Flowered Pal either because they're not kids. Priya and Vivian, they're toddlers and babies. Oh, you can have guests blow bubbles. Okay, but that's not what we want to do. Gather. So we've had them take their seats. Send down one sim. Send down John. Where are you? Okay, he's going down the aisle first. Okay, John. Wait. I want to see this. This is cute. I've never actually... Well, have I seen this? I can't remember if this worked. I haven't actually seen this animation. He's crying. That's super cute. Okay, there... Wait. What's happening? What's going on? Shen, why are you here? This is a private wedding. Okay, well. Louis just walked Jen down the aisle. Let's see. Can you guys exchange vows now?
Exchange vows. Okay, all right. Now they're exchanging vows.
Yay!
I'm assuming this animation's the same.
All right, so now they're exchanging vows. They're getting married. I'm so excited for them. We're gonna have the reception after this. So this is just the ceremony here, but they're so cute. I'm excited for them. Yay! Okay, yay, they're married. There was no, like, fireworks things or... Oh, Shen, why are you here? Shen, you're not supposed to be here. Oh, yay, they're all waiting. What is happening? Oh my gosh. Oh, this is Baroness. We need to stop. Y'all, I'm sorry. This is a private event. I can't tell a child to leave. Why are you here? This was supposed to be. Why are random people allowed in here? They're not supposed to be. Okay, yay, they're married. Priya and, oh my gosh, did Vivian wear white to a wedding? Also the shoes. Oh my goodness gracious. Oh my gosh, look at the little runaway, basically newborn.
Okay, so we're now at the wedding reception, and we are having this at now one of the Willow Creek palaces, which I'm actually debating maybe John and Genevieve will be living in. They're supposed to be now, let me actually change their name. Actually, I'll do that in a bit. So they're now the Duchess and Duke Consort of Willow Creek, and they will, yeah, I think that
doesn't live here. So this palace was built by Riley. And then there's actually a new main Willow Creek Palace too, which we will definitely see in an episode soon. But I have a stream where I toured both of those palaces in the description below. So you guys can watch that there. And I'm so excited for you guys to see if you haven't yet, because they are stunning. They are so pretty. Yeah, so I thought that back here would be the perfect place to have the reception. This is actually in the lot where the park used to be. This is also the lot where Corn Farm's wedding was. But this, I'm kind of like, I replace lots as needed. I just have to show this. Hold on. Look at this. So this is based off of the Palace of Versailles and the Hall of Mirrors. I love it so much. It's so pretty. Riley did an amazing job. And Marco is the one who built the main Willow Creek Palace. And it is so stunning. You guys will see. So yeah. Okay. All right. But yeah, we're just doing the reception here. And then we'll move on, because we do have a lot to get to in this episode. But I'm going to have them have their first dance. So gather ceremony activities, gather for first dance, and then have first dance with Princess Genevieve. Where are they going for their first dance? What are you doing? Why did you go all the way out here to have your first dance? What? What? Okay, well, they're having their first dance. I mean, it's super cute. I like the dancing animations that we have now. All right, now I'm gonna try to give toast. So I had Corn Boy say, let's have toasts. And you are going to give a toast. And Genevieve and John, you're going to have guests dance. No, you're gonna sit. Gather for toast. Okay, there we go. Wait, Cornelius, did you just give the toast? Wait, give another toast. You, no one else, hold on. All right, Cornelius is giving a toast, even though no one was there yet, but that's fine. Okay, well, no. They're like, yeah, okay, yes. Apparently, it's working, kind of. Also, this little area, I figured, like, it'll light up a bit more at night, but they're having kind of like an evening thing. So they'll, like, dance all night. Okay, well, we have everyone gathered at least. They're now gathering for cake. So I'm going to have Genevieve cut cake with John. John, do you and Takashi not get along? What happened? You guys are like, really? I don't know what happened. Oh my gosh, that knife is huge. Okay, oh.
Wait, they're supposed to get the first cake. People, hello.
You just helped yourself. Also, why is Elena, she looked frustrated. I don't know why. I don't know why they're going inside for this. You guys could just do it like right there in front of each other, in front of like the guests. You guys could just do the cake in front of the guests. Okay, oh, that was it. All right, John, you good? You put it on the floor, okay. I don't know why you guys are eating cake in here. You both look so serious. Elena, what's wrong?
Okay, I mean, we pretty much did everything. They're supposed to have speeches, but yay, they're married, yay.
We got some bugs happening. I guess that's to be expected. I mean, I think that was fine. It was okay. Things somewhat worked. But Genevieve and John are married, and they're gonna go on their honeymoon, and then they are now the Duchess and Duke Consort of Willow Creek, and I'm so excited for them. Yay!
Okay, so we're now in Henford on Bagley with the Windenburg royal family, and if you guys saw the story posts that I had posted leading up to this episode, you guys know that they were supposed to be here for the weekend, so like a little holiday weekend. So this is the first time Caspian is here with them, and the first time he's staying here with them. And so they're really excited about that. And then Lady Tally, which is Nani's little sister, is here with Cedric, and they're super close friends. So they've had their weekend here. They've all been having fun. They've kind of been like doing stuff together and doing their own thing. They were just, I guess they're talking. So this is Tally. They have little friendship bracelets, her and Cedric, but you can't see hers because it's under the sweater. So that's fine. It looks like Jabari and Amira are currently watching TV together, even though Amira's not actually sitting down. And then Alice May and Caspian. Oh, they're making out on the bench by the lake. This is supposed to be private property, so technically no one would see them, even though people are going to be walking by. But that's what they're currently doing. Okay. But they're just out here. Well, they were looking at the stars together. I don't know who this is. I'm going to tell them to go away because there's not supposed to be anybody here. Let them be. Let them enjoy their time here. So I kind of like figured they would all be riding horses together, which I'm still salty that we don't have horses, but they would be doing that. They're both very flirty and they're having an arbor's exchange, and I love that they're still making out with each other. So there were four story posts posted of like this story specifically. So one of
Cedric and Alice May, which was really just for fun, but AM does mention that her and Caspian have not said I love you to each other yet, but she does feel like she's like there with him. And then the next post was Cedric asking if he could go on a movie date with him and Sterling, like just him and Sterling, and Jabari was like, no, you're 12, not yet. So you guys could see that conversation in that story post. And we also did see Alice May get a little sassy in that post since Amira still isn't letting her and Caspian go public, and we'll talk about that more later. And then the next post was of Caspian and his dad Maleko, and Caspian asking his dad how to know if he's in love, because he also feels like he's there with Alice May. And Caspian also shares his fears due to what he knows, or what he thinks he knows about his parents' divorce. So he thinks it's just because they fell out of love. But if you remember the intro from season 2, part 53, I think, it was a long time ago, so no worries if you don't, but I will link it below. But they did get divorced because Maleko cheated on Nia twice, so Caspian doesn't know that yet. And then the last story post is of Amira and Jabari, and it just gives you a little bit more insight about what's going through Amira's head about not letting CasMay go public, but we'll see more of that later. So yeah, now they're still making out. Here's the thing. I literally just found out this didn't work for them, and I'm so sad, but I was gonna try the Road to Romance mod by Lumpino, and I was super excited because it has this interaction where they can say I love you, or are they getting up to chat, but it doesn't work for teenagers. And I was like, wait, what? That's literally all I wanted was for them to say I love you to each other. I know there's like a profess undying love thing, and I did say in the beginning of this video that we would see it, but basically I'll go over it real quick. I might keep it if I like it for others, but I wanted to use it for CasMay. That's all I cared about right now. But yeah, there's a romance skill. So working on the romance skill gives Sims a chance to be better at partners and improve their relationship. Gain romance skill by using romance interactions or romantic interactions and researching on the computer. So it really just focuses on the romance interaction specifically. It just adds a bit more for them. You can like gain more skill by doing the romantic interactions. You can go do something together. You can go to couple counseling, so I might use this for Dean and Leilana because the other one wasn't like as detailed as I thought it was going to be. Offer to go to drinks, offer to go out with friends, offer to go for a walk. So these are all rabbit holes, but the teens can do this, but that's apparently the only thing they can do. You can make a funny flirty compliment. You can make future plans. So this is what I wanted with like CasMay, because I think they might start. I know they're still fairly young, but they've been dating for a while. You can like reaffirm devotion, share deeply personal thoughts. If any of these are already like are not part of the mod, I apologize. These are just the ones I'm seeing, so I'm assuming that they're from the mod. You can talk about life together. Yeah, but you should be able to like say I love you, but yeah, it's not available for teens, which I am disappointed, very disappointed, because I was like relying on this for this episode. But yeah, anyway, maybe we can see more of this for other couples. Oh, they're hugging. They're really cute. I want you guys to say I love you. But anyway, they're supposed to be here to stargaze, so they've been here. It's like Saturday night now. I figured they came on like a Friday night. They rode horses. We'll say that they did, so they can stargaze now. We don't spend enough time in Henford on Magley. It's so pretty. It's so gorgeous. I love this place. It's stunning. They're so cute. But I wanted them to say I love you like at the same time, because they both were thinking about it. So I think it'd be cute if they said I love you to each other at the same time, and then I feel like they would start like giggling afterwards. So I will do a story post on this, and we'll see. And I'm so sorry. If anyone knows of another mod that lets you do this for teenagers, please let me know. I've looked into like, there's like a Sims 3 interactions, like romantic interactions one, but I didn't see it on there. Anyway, Caspian is like, he was kind of worried about this, and he was a little bit like, he's been a little guarded. He tends to be a little guarded sometimes. And as you guys saw in the story post, a lot of that being because of his parents' divorce, which I know a lot of people experience on their own too. I've had people say that they also feel the same way. So I totally get that, and I think that it would have affected Caspian too, but his dad gave him some advice. His dad didn't tell him yet about him and his mom. He wants to, as you guys also saw in the story post. He knows he has to. He just has been scared to. Him and Caspian are super close, and he's scared to ruin that relationship with his son. But he knows that he should tell him, so we'll see more about that later too. I haven't had them be like girlfriend and boyfriend specifically yet, because they're secret boyfriend and girlfriend, and that's not an option. You know what would be so fun? Like a forbidden romance mod or something like that, to where they could be secret and
and like have to hide it from people. Oh, that would be so much fun. I would love. Oh, what did I click? I don't know what I clicked. I'm scared what I clicked.
You know, they probably would also talk about Kaleo coming back. I think Alice May is probably a bit anxious. Caspian, I think he's just worried about Alice May. I know the whole thing happened with him and Kaleo, but I think he knows now that like he's like, Kaleo can't do anything.
Is that a fox? Is that a little fox? Also, where's Benji? Benji, are you having fun in Henford? Benji, do you want to chase foxes around? Oh, he's hanging out with Cedric and Tally. He's like, I don't know what my mother's doing right now. My mother is on a date. She didn't want to bring me on a date.
I don't know. Maybe she did. Maybe Benji was supposed to stay inside because they've got to worry about foxes and all that stuff out here. So yeah, I guess because I can't have them say I love you, which I'm still so sad about, she's professing her undying love, which we'll pretend is saying I love you. Maybe they're both saying it to each other now. All right, Caspian, say it too. They're saying it at the same time to each other. But anyway, point is, I feel like this would push Alice May even more to want to go public with Caspian. I feel like she's already wanted to. Amira has like been making them stay secret for so long, and as we saw, Alice May was already getting frustrated about it, and she's getting annoyed, and she wants to go public with Caspian, and them saying I love you to each other, I think would push her even more to want to go public and ask. Okay. But I think it would push her even more to want them to go public. So they're having their little date. They're enjoying their time together, the weekend together, and then I think Alice May is going to plan to talk to Amira the next morning. Okay, so it's now the next morning, and Alice May she was super happy about how last night it went with Caspian. She has also been thinking, she's like, okay, I'm going to confront my mother. I am going to talk to her. So Amira's in her office, and Alice May's in here like, hi, can I talk to you? Amira doesn't know what this is about. She's like, sure. I don't even know if there's something I can do. I guess deep conversation? That's kind of the only thing I can think of that would work. So Alice May, she's sitting down and bringing this up to her mother, asking, hey mom, can I talk to you? I know like you've kind of said that I wasn't ready, but I think that I am ready for Caspian and I to go public. And I feel like Amira hearing this would just like immediately, like, she doesn't want to talk about it. She doesn't want to like open up about it. So I think she would immediately brush Alice May off as soon as she hears what it's about. So I'm going to have her brush off. Can you brush her off? I was, I guess, argue about house rules. I know there's a brush off option. I was gonna have her do that. All right, so I'll argue about house rules. Speaking of, guys, I'm so excited for the high school pack to come out. I think the live stream will be by the time this episode comes out, but as of now, it hasn't come out yet. I think it's Tuesday. The live stream's on Friday for the details of it. Oh, I mean, hold on. Wait, they're fighting. It's dramatic. Let me fit it. I'll talk about it later. Okay. All right. So they're arguing, and Amir is like, no, we're not talking about this. I don't think Alice May would yell back yet. So that's why I didn't want to do the arguing. I just wanted her to brush Amira off. Or sorry, I wanted Amira to brush Alice May off and just like walk away. And I think Alice May would be like, are you kidding? Like, what the heck was that? So that's why I just wanted her to brush her off. I was gonna have her say go away, but I think I'm gonna just have Amira walk out. But yeah, I think that Alice May was already frustrated about this, and she finally got up the courage and was like, okay, I'm gonna talk to my mom about this. I'm gonna be like mature about it. I'm gonna bring it up to her, talk about it. And as soon as she does, as soon as she mentions it, Amira just like brushed her off. So now she's like even more frustrated. So we're gonna see more about that later. I will have a story post of this so you guys will see. And we're gonna leave them to the rest of the weekend here, which might be slightly tense between Alice May and Amira, but that is all we'll do here. They'll have fun for the rest of the weekend. Cedric and Tally have no idea what's going on. Cedric's there. I don't know what Tally's doing. They'll enjoy their weekend. Oh, okay. Oh, Jabari's talking to Tally and Caspian, and Benji's in here too. Interesting. Okay. Oh, Caspian fell out of range to earn the emotional control trait. He was doing pretty good. So we'll see more of that later. Also, I did mention that Alice May was in a rebellious phase too. So yeah, we'll see more about this. Okay, so we're now at the Oasis Springs Palace, and trigger warning for infertility as well. Wow, I'll put a timestamp on the screen if you would like to skip or if you would like to come back to it later. So we're checking in on Arya and Gabriel. And in the last episode, we left off with Arya finding out that she is infertile and Gabriel finding out that he has low fertility. And I did do two story posts about the events from the last episode, but you guys can find those below as well. Basically, just going into detail of everything that we saw. They did try IVF and it didn't work, and I imagine they would probably be trying several times, so I guess realistically this would take place over like a while. But during the process, Arya would be taking hormones to better her chances of getting pregnant, so her hormones are super out of whack right now, and obviously she's really stressed, and her and Gabriel, they're going through a lot right now. And out of the family, I think she would have confided in Kimmy, so Kimmy knows what's going on, Naya knows what's going on, Gabriel's gone right now, Naya knows what's going on. I think Manuel and Aisha would know that Arya and Gabriel are probably like having trouble getting pregnant. I don't think they would know the details of it though. Like, especially Aisha too, because Aisha and Arya, one, don't get along. Two, Aisha lives in San Myshuno. She's currently visiting for the weekend right now. And so we're about to see something. Here's the thing. I imagine Aisha is like just getting back from San Myshuno, or I guess she's visiting for the week. It's Sunday. She's visiting for the week. So Aisha pretends she's got like her little suitcase. I have a story post of this too, but or like suitcase or bag. And I imagine that her assistant probably puts a bunch of fashion magazines and like celebrity magazines on her desk, like maybe ones featuring her designs. And you guys know that gossip magazines are writing stuff about Gabriel and Arya, about why they haven't had a kid yet. I imagine that Aisha, she's probably coming straight from her office in San Myshuno, and she like, okay, so I'm just like, picture this scene. You guys will see it in a story post, but basically maybe she like drops the magazines or something like that, and Arya sees it. Arya's just chilling here reading a book. Arya would see it. She's been like avoiding the media and all that stuff. She probably has an idea of what's going on, but maybe she's like avoided it so much, especially since they've gotten like further into this process, her and Gabriel. Also because, of course, like I mentioned, like she's just under so much stress and her hormones are just everywhere right now. So maybe she sees it and flips out. Like, why would you bring that in here? Let me see. So yell at, accused of spying. Oh yeah, that's because she's paranoid. So I had that she was paranoid because she's like, it was mostly that she just like cares a lot about what people think. Wait. Aisha, come back here. Come back here. Yo, you guys are in here. You guys are arguing in here. Okay. And of course, like Aisha, I don't think she would purposefully had brought that home. Like, maybe the point of the magazine mostly, where are you guys going? Maybe the point of the magazine was like, it had Aisha's design on it again, but it just happened to also have like a little part about Arya and Gabriel in there. And so Arya is yelling at Aisha. Aisha's getting really defensive. Like, what the heck is going on? And like, Aisha and Arya are very different. Aisha doesn't care what people think about her. She's not very traditional. She typically goes against like the norm, whereas Arya cares a lot about what people think. She's very traditional. She doesn't understand how Aisha can just do whatever. So anyway, they're pretend they're getting in this huge fight. They're having an offensive conversation. But don't throw your drink, please. Maybe Naya walks in. I don't know if she like hears this or not. Maybe Naya walks in. Yeah, Aisha's just like, what the heck is going on? Naya, get in here, your daughter's. She's like, what is going on? Can you break up? Oh, Arya, she's crying. Can you break up a fight? Maybe, you know what? Maybe, okay, so maybe now Arya, oh wow, that's a lot. I did that. Maybe now Arya goes up to her room. Gabriel's not home yet. Go here. Oh, now you're fine. She was sad before because she took another pregnancy test and it was negative. They're having an aggravating conversation. I was expecting her to be more upset. I was gonna have her go to her room and cool off, but it says she's fine. There's the brush off interaction that I wanted Amira to do to Alice May. Okay, there we go. All right, now Arya's angry. Now she's enraged. Okay, I guess you'll come here and cool off. Where do you, like, maybe here? Try to calm down. Okay, now she's just storming off to her room. And I feel like Aisha, well, Naya was supposed to be in here, but she was dancing in there. But I feel like Aisha would be like, what the heck was that? And Naya is like, listen, Arya's going through a lot right now. Can you hug her? I was gonna see if you could try to calm her down. Try to calm down, there you go. I do think that Naya would probably tell Aisha what was going on, because she knows the gist of it. And it's not that Arya is like trying to keep it, she's trying to keep it from like the public, but like, I don't think she'd be trying to purposely keep it from her family. She just doesn't really talk to Aisha. So I feel like Naya would probably tell Aisha what was going on and tell her the details of things and tell her like they're under a lot of stress right now and all that stuff. And Aisha would probably be like, I didn't know that. Maybe she offers to talk to Arya, and maybe Naya is just like, just wait a bit until she cools off. So We're gonna wait until she cools off. Okay, so I fast forwarded a few hours. Arya's... Oh, she's fine now. Okay. Well, that was easy. Oh, emotional meltdown. Oh, no. But maybe Aisha comes and like, can you like knock on the door? Pretend she knocks on the door. I don't know if I can stop Arya from having an emotional meltdown. I think she's going to regardless. Can I like reset you? There you go. Okay. So she's actually fine. I wasn't expecting her to be like suddenly okay. But she's, I don't think completely cooled off, but cooled off a little. All right. So Aisha's in here now. Can you, deep personal conversation. Can you apologize? Well, I think she would just say like, look, mom told me about earlier. Like, sorry about that. And Arya just be like, no, I'm sorry too. If you didn't know that that was in the magazines and you didn't purposely bring it home, then I believe you. And then I feel like Arya would probably start confiding in her and just letting her know, like, this is what Gabriel and I have been going through. It's been really hard. So deep personal conversation. So just telling Aisha everything that has been going on, like the process of them trying to get pregnant and like the failures of it and how much it's been hurting and all that stuff. And Aisha is listening to this. Maybe Aisha does suggest surrogacy. I know a lot of people have brought that up, like either surrogacy or a donor. And I did mention last time that Arya just, she just doesn't think she can do that. Like she, yes, she does want kids. She really wants to be a mother. That's what she's always wanted. I think Aisha would be like, okay, like it's fine. You don't have to go into detail about why you don't want that. And then I feel like Aisha would like think about it and be like, have you considered adoption? I don't think this would have been something Arya even thought about, honestly, because like we've had a few nobles that have adopted, like Makai adopting Jessica, for example, but we've never had a future monarch or current monarch do this. So I feel like Arya would be like, can we do that? And as I mentioned, Aisha's very like, she goes against the norm. She's not very traditional. And Arya is. So I feel like Aisha would be like, well, why not? Like, you really want kids. I know this is something you've always wanted. They wouldn't be in line for the throne just because the current rule is that they have to be descended from like the bloodline of the royal family. But Aisha is like, that shouldn't matter. So I think this would just be like a nice little moment with Arya and Aisha. I'm like, Arya listening to this and thinking about it. Maybe Aisha is like, I mean, I think you'd be a great mother, which is probably the nicest thing she's ever said to Arya. Yeah. So I think this would be a big thing. And Arya's starting to think about this, and she's gonna talk to Gabriel about this. I do think Arya would also mention, because I did mention, like, I showed the family tree of the Oasis Springs royal family just to give people some background, because we don't normally focus on them, so I just wanted to, like, give some details for anyone who didn't know. Kimmy did give up her place in line for the throne, so she's not in line. So technically, after Arya, it's Aisha, but I think Aisha would mention, like, now that this is going on, and be like, I think I'm gonna go ahead and just give up my place in line for the throne, because for multiple reasons. One, Aisha doesn't want to be queen. That's not something she would ever want. Okay, they're walking away. Why are you sad? I think it's from the emotion bomb thing. But you know what? While they're doing this too, I'm going to have Arya talk to Gabriel about the adoption, because I'm pretty sure they can do that with the Woohoo wellness mod. But yeah, Aisha doesn't want to be queen. This has never been something she wants. She also like doesn't, out of any of the royals, really, she's the one who does her royal duties the least, because she has a job. She is a couture fashion designer. Like, she has other obligations. So she wants to go ahead and take her place out. She knows that people would, just because that is the way Aisha is, people might make a big deal out of it when they find out that Arya and Gabriel do adopt and have a child that's like not in line for the throne, which like we'll talk about more later. So yeah, where are you, Gabriel? Just talk to your wife. So now Arya's dancing. Pregnancy and family discuss adopting a child. So she's gonna see what Gabriel thinks about this. I probably think Gabriel would be along the same lines too, of like they just hadn't thought about it before. Kissing. But they just hadn't like thought about it. It just hadn't crossed their mind. Oh yeah, okay, so he can decide. So Princess Arya is asking Prince Gabriel whether he would agree to adopting a child. Princess Arya wants to look at adoption procedures to expand the family. I mean, I think Gabriel would be like, I mean, yeah, if that's what you want, I would want that too. So he's like, all right, let's look into this. So yeah, they're thinking of adopting. This will be like a long process for them that will continue the next episode. But now this is, I think, what they have officially decided. So we will see more of them in the next episode. They're both really happy now too, which is super cute, and then Aisha's just jamming and dancing right in between them. Okay, so I did mention that we would be having some babies in this episode. So I forgot to put in the last episode that Diana was pregnant. Diana was pregnant. She is pregnant and she's having her baby now. Yay! I know that's awfully quick. And then as you guys know, Ava was staying with the
like Amira and all of them. She was just trying to go through things, figure things out. She went to go stay with Diana Abraham for a bit, just because Diana was like about to have her baby. So she'll probably stay here for a bit too. Ava's doing a bit better. I think she's still got a bit to go. I think being with her grandkids definitely helps her a lot. I might get her a cat, maybe a couple cats. Maybe we'll do that on stream one day. I think she would want some cats too. Anyway, we got little Vincent. He's about to get a little sibling. Hug lovingly. I think that your relationship should be higher. Also, Ava, what's your relationship with him? Oh, okay. It's hard to keep up with the relationships and stuff because there's so many Sims, but I need to do this. They should have more. Maybe Ava, you want to read him a toddler book because Diana's like about to go into labor. Also, okay, so while Diana's in labor, we're gonna do something too, which is kind of sad, but I think would definitely happen. Where's William? William's next door. All right, I've got William. This isn't happening at their house. This is happening at William's house. So you know the whole thing with Ember and how Ember thought William was the dad. Oh, Abraham is your parenting level only on one. I should increase that. But yeah, you know how all that happened. I think that probably would have gotten out. And I think that his girlfriend, Lady Gia's family, probably would have heard about it. And I think they would have gotten upset. Even though William's not the father, I think just with their mindset and how they are, I think they would be upset that there was even the possibility of him being the father. And maybe they don't want their daughter to get like mixed up into that, which is unfair, yes, but I think that would be realistically what would happen. So I'm gonna have Gia come over. I'm gonna invite Gia over. Lady Gia. Tried to hang out at her a lot. Okay, I don't know where Gia is, but Diana's in labor. So Diana, have baby at hospital, send alone. Her and Abraham will go to the hospital to have the baby. Okay, there she is. Oh, and they're going to the hospital right next door. I'm doing this here because William lives next door. Actions control sim. So, oh, why are you enraged? I'm not okay. Rock group small 01. What? Is it because she's feeling rebellious? I don't know why she's... Oh, maybe she's upset that she has to break up with William. That could be a thing. Okay, complain about partners, family. You can do that? Interesting. Okay, so she's got to break up with William. Listen, at least it wasn't at like... I know Genevieve only invited us like a really small group and just her family, but like at least it wasn't at Genevieve's wedding because that would have been another Willow Creek princess wedding that William got broken up at. Poor baby. I'm so sorry, William. I'm so sorry. Lady Gia just broke up with Lord William. Yeah, maybe she was upset that she... Oh, okay. And now, immediately, Diana had her baby. Okay. So, Diana and Abraham had another boy. And so we're gonna go with, I know this isn't like a super famous artist, and I know that was like kind of the theme with them, but I think I'm gonna go with Samuel, who is, so Ash, who made Abraham, suggested this, and it is because the artist Samuel Butcher, he's an American artist, but he's the one who makes the Precious Moments figurines, which technically, like, I don't do real world things, but I feel like if I have an equivalent in this world, like, Diana would be super into those. I feel like she would love them so much. So this is going to be Lord Samuel. But they had a baby and there's confetti, yay! Oh, and then we've got this going on here. I'm so sorry. I mean, they weren't dating for like that long. Maybe a few months. I feel like he was probably didn't have like super, super, super strong feelings, like as much as he did with Minerva anyway. So I think he'd be upset, but I don't think he'd be like devastated about this. Okay, Desta. Okay, we were gonna go to UKSD to Salvadorada, but Desta's literally walking by right now. I don't think I'm gonna, she's already here, and I know it'll take a while to load into the Salvadorada Palace, so I think I'm just going to have her baby here. So if you guys do remember, it might have gotten lost in the chaos, but Desta got pregnant in the last episode, and I know this is super fast for her to be having her baby. Normally, I would wait an episode in between before she would have her baby, and I know it's not gonna match with the timeline and everything, but I want them to have their babies this episode because I'm gonna start working on a royal family tree video and I want the babies to be on that tree. So we're gonna go ahead and have them have the baby, which is again pretty early, but just, I don't know, pretend that
isn't. I was gonna teleport Adric here, teleport command, teleport world sim, just so he can be here. Even though they're gonna go to the hospital and all that stuff, we just want them to have them have their baby. All right, Queen Desta is bursting with anticipation to meet her new bundle of joy. Adric is freaking out. They're having their second child. Osiris is at home with grandma. So we're going to have baby at the hospital, send alone. So this is just a lot where everything is happening, apparently. So they're gonna have their baby. I'm so excited. Okay, so they had a baby girl. So Osiris has a little sister. All right, so they're gonna name her Princess MM. Princess MM. And this is a Bibio for peace. So I think that would be a really, really pretty name. So yay. All right, we'll have Desta come back here. Technically, she's going home, but they have a baby girl and I will post a picture of them with her. So yay, we had three babies born in this episode. We had a lot going on and now we're about to have even more going on. We're gonna go to the Guangxi Palace. All right, so we're now at the Guangxi Palace. It's supposed to be nighttime. It's getting there. It's like 7 p.m. I think that's a good time. So we're here. The event that's happening is an anniversary party for Han and Araminta. We're pretending. We got a cake. I'm using the wedding pack as much as I can. Serve assortment. And fill fountain with fruit punch. Yay, food. And a pretty cake. It's so pretty. And we can do toast too. I'm just gonna wait for everyone to get here. Honestly, the reason why we're here is Eddie's walking in right this second. Kaleo. I'll tell you guys, whoa, I don't know what just happened. He just glitched. I'll get to why in a second because y'all are probably confused. So, Kaleo, I'm gonna control you, sir. I think you're feeling down in the dumps, which is actually pretty accurate here. So sit. So Kaleo's back from military school. And again, I'll get to why I'm talking about this in the Guangxi Palace in a bit. We're waiting for people to show up. People should be coming in soon. Maybe if I call people to the mail, I don't think Kaleo would want to, but let's just call to meal so people can actually come over here. Kaleo, you're just gonna keep sitting because you're sulking. Alice May isn't here. None of the teen group are here. Well, as you guys know too, that with Alice May, they basically have a restraining order. Oh my gosh, you're naked. Stop. Wait, put some clothes on, please, ma'am. Didn't we pick outfits for you like 12 times on stream? Why do they keep going missing? I'm picking anything at this point. But okay, well, that's fine. What was I saying? So him and Alice May aren't allowed to be at the same event. I think that they would have, like, managers who would coordinate that. So, like, if Alice May is going to an event, Kaleo's manager is like, okay, well, you're not going to this one. And they've got, like, priority for certain events, too. Wait, Kaleo, stop. What are you doing? Are you crying? Oh, okay, you're just getting up to cry. All right, fine. Don't check on the toddler. I think you're just sitting. Just sit, sir. So I'll have a little story post of this, too, of, like, before the party and checking in with Kaleo. He's back from military school, of course. And I think ever since he's gotten back, Leilana and Dean have been trying to get him to go to therapy. And I can see Kaleo just like completely refusing to go. Part of him honestly might be embarrassed to go, like among other reasons. He doesn't want to go. He won't even try it. He doesn't think it'll help. And Leilana and Dean are like trying to figure out how to get him to go. Honestly, Leilana could probably just put her foot down about it, but she's like trying. They're trying over the course of these 8 months. They're trying harder. They have been trying to work through things. Not everything has been going smoothly, but like they're trying and they've got more work to do and they are trying to help Kaleo too. Dean, don't show up like this, please. Why did you show up shirtless? I can imagine like the families kind of just like mingling in the corner. Kimmy's supposed to be here, Makana's supposed to be here. Again, it's a smaller event. The teens aren't here. Maybe there's other reasons why the other teens couldn't come. Maybe William didn't want to come because his ex-girlfriend G is here. Also, Emperor Liwei, why are you naked too? Everyone is naked, stop it. Anyway, so Kaleo's kind of like sulking here, pretending he's not happy, pretending he was sad like he was just a second ago. And Kaleo's like, I mean, he's refusing. Oh, okay, well, you've got like kids next to you, but he's like refusing to get help. He's just been sulking. I mean, he lost all his friends. I mean, all of these are the consequences of his own actions, but he's just basically been sulking a lot. I can't get over the fact that he's happy. I might cheat it so he's not, because he was sad just a second ago. I don't know if like tense. Grumpy. He's just grumpy. I don't know if that's the, I don't know. Anyway. So, okay. Here's the thing. And I think I've mentioned this before about like tabloids reporting that Alice May and Kaleo, probably before the whole thing with Alice May and Caspian came out, people thinking that Alice May and Kaleo were dating. And I'm sure Kaleo loved that. Like the fact that people always assumed that they were together and like no one would really try to, like no one in the Seven Kingdoms at least that knew of them would really try anything with them. Cause they thought they were a thing. Played The Sims 4 for 24 hours. I'm pretty sure I've played for more than
that.
So that's why I picked this event to be at Guangxi, because they're close to Qinqing, which is Han's kingdom, and they're not a part of the Alliance of the Seven Kingdoms. I love that we're getting that with Kaleo as a snob. Yes, we do that. So I do feel like there'd be some noble girls from Qinqing here. As we saw, there's Jia, who is William's ex-girlfriend. Well, she was just talking to her group of friends here. So there's this girl here. This is Kanda. She just recently got out of a relationship, and she's like ready to enjoy single life. I can kind of see her making eyes at Kaleo across the way. She doesn't know Kaleo. She doesn't know what he's like. Maybe she does recognize him. Maybe like something comes up. Because like Jia obviously knows Alice May. Maybe she would have recognized Kaleo. Well, Jia's supposed to be here talking to them. But like, I don't think she would have known exactly what happened with Kaleo, with William and all of them. Because again, William didn't date her for that long. And I don't even know if he would have wanted to get into it, honestly, because Kaleo was gone. They were just like not worrying about him. Okay. Oh, do you see them high five? She's like, all right, I'm going to go talk to him. Her friend's probably like, yeah, you go. Oh, wait, Kanda. Wait, come back. Where are you going? Makana, you're walking by shirtless. Oh my God. She's like literally going up to Kaleo and flirting with him. Oh no, don't bring your mom into this conversation. Stop it. I'm trying to do a whole scene with all this chaos in The Sims going on. Why is kiss neck already an option? Why has their relationship gone up so fast? Oh my gosh. I kind of figured that she would come off like really strong, but I kind of thought that maybe Kaleo at first wouldn't really take that much into it. Like he would be like, I'm sorry, who are you? Because I mean, we saw Kaleo's a snob. We saw how we know how he is. Oh my gosh, they're flirting so much. Okay, but we know how Kaleo is. I kind of figured he'd be like, I'm sorry, who are you? Like when she first approaches him. And I do think like Kanda's gorgeous, but I think that Kaleo is still hung up on Alice May, which we'll get more into later. Whoa, wait, where are you guys going? Wait, no. Guys. Oh my God. That was so fast. Okay, that is the fastest hookup I've ever seen in my life. So Kaleo has the hungry for love lifestyle. Kanda has the single and loving it lifestyle, which I also feel like Aisha would probably have. But the hungry for love one fit Kaleo, I think, really well. Maybe that's why this happened so fast. Anyway, I feel like that kind of shows like Kanda, again, is more like she was just looking for a hookup. And I feel like maybe Kaleo would say that at first too. But maybe Kaleo would say that like that he wasn't really looking for anything when she's first hitting on him. And then maybe she was like, oh, that's okay, I'm not either. And then maybe she initiated. Maybe she like told him to meet her there. I don't think they would go there together. Oh my God. That was so fast. I can see this starting a bit of a hoe phase for Kaleo, to put it lightly. I don't know how else to say that. A woohoo phase. A multiple woohooinger phase. But just because like with Kaleo, as I mentioned, he's like, he's not trying to get help or anything like that. I have no judgment for anyone who goes through a woohooing phase. I'm gonna call it a hoe phase. I'm sorry. A hoe phase. I don't, no judgment. Really, do I think that hoe phases are a good way to take care of your internal and mental problems? No, absolutely not. But again, Kaleo's refusing to get help or anything of that sort. It just seems very realistic that this would happen. Like that Kaleo would do this. He, again, hungry for love, fits him very well. I don't think he's necessarily looking to be in a relationship with the first girl that he sees, but like, you know, this would take care of the other aspects of things. Anyway, I don't think the whole phase is going to be something we would do in an episode. That would probably be on a stream, and maybe I'll show clips of it in an episode. All right, yeah, they just... So yeah, anyway, that's why we were at the Guangxi Palace. I didn't think it would make sense. Any other girls who were in the Alliance of the Seven Kingdoms... Oh good, there's a party. Any other girls... Oh, Makana's still shirtless. Any other girls that were in the Alliance of the Seven Kingdoms would have like either known Kaleo and known what's going on, or they're related to Kaleo. There just wasn't a whole lot of options. So I thought it would be someone that wouldn't know him, and the only place that made sense would be that she was from Qinqing. So that's what's going on with Kaleo. He wasn't gonna get better overnight. Military school was not gonna fix him. It might have fixed a few manners, but that doesn't fix someone with as deep of issues as Kaleo has. And this isn't going to fix Kaleo either. This is just, we're just checking in with him and seeing what was going on and how he's currently dealing with things, but we're gonna see more about it later as well. Also, I forgot to get into this before, but really quickly, just want to mention the high school pack, because I'm so excited, and
it. I was gonna talk about it before, but then it got serious, then I forgot. So, I'm so excited, it's coming out really soon.
I think the next teen, because I think it's too late for our current teens to go to high school, but I think Cedric's the next one. Like, he'll be aging up after the next big thing in Alice May stories. It'll be after a time skip, so I don't want to say like too soon, but like soon enough. But I think he'd be going around the time that Alice May would be going to university. So what do you guys think about doing a mini series for Cedric and Alice May? So it would be following them both, like one mini series following them both. So let me know what you guys think in the comments below. They would kind of be, I guess, like the Charles and Bellatrix mini series. But I think that's all we're gonna do for this episode. So we're gonna go ahead and end it here.
I've been filming for so long that it's nighttime here already. If you remember the beginning of the episode, it was daytime, like the sun was shining. Now it's pitch black outside. So yeah, that's how this episode went. No, this was fun. We had a lot going on in this episode again. Let me know what you guys think of everything again. I know we had a lot happening. We had the whole thing with Ember and Liam. We had the wedding with Genevieve and John. We had the whole thing with CasMay and the whole situation and them saying I love you to each other though. But yeah, the whole situation with Amira and not letting them go public. And we got babies born. And then this whole thing checking in with Kaleo.
Oh, and Arya and Gabriel. Arya and Gabriel. They've decided to adopt. So that's gonna be the process that they're going through next.
So we'll see more about that in the next episode and we'll see story posts and all that too. And I'm so excited for them.
So if you enjoyed this, make sure you hit that like button. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button if you have not already and turn on your notifications. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.